What's up, Vault Hunters? Today we're going through Flexbox. It's a CSS feature to make simple layouts, and it really rocks. It will help you to give your items order and to align. It's very easy to use and will save you lots of time. Here we have a page with four cards of Borderlands characters besides each other. Let's see what exactly is going on. There's a full width div acting as a row container, and the space is divided equally between the cards to fit. This is because I set the display property to flex, which will make all direct children flex items. By default, Flexbox will put the items in a row, from left to right. The only other option is to use the vertical axis instead of the horizontal axis, which is known as column. So it's only a row or a column. Basically, it is just one direction. This is what my page would look like without Flexbox. Each div is a block element, which is taking the whole row. Look what would happen if I just apply display flex to the container. As you can see, the flex items are now aligned in a row, which is the default setting. So this will have the same effect. Now let's look into justify content. This will place the items along the main axis, which in this case is a row. The default value is flex start, which will place the items from the left to the right, as it is currently. I'll make the card smaller so you can see the effect better. The inverse of flex start is flex end, which will start the items from the right. There's also the space around option, which will divide the space evenly between all the items, making it twice as large when in between. Space evenly is almost the same as space around, but it will not leave twice as large the space between items. And finally, there is space between, which is similar to space around, but it does not apply any space in the beginning or in the end of the axis. Okay, so how do I move Zane to the right while all the others are on the left? We can use margins for this. If you apply margin left auto, it will put it all the way to the right. So far, we have used width to size our elements, but Flexbox can be super responsive. Let me show you. If we set flex 1 on each flex item, all the space will be used. Why? Flex is like a ratio. We gave each flex item the same number, so they are taking equal space. If we set the flex of Amara to 2, it will take twice as much space as the others. If we give flex a fixed width, while the others a flex of 1, they will take all the remaining space after sizing flex. Amazing. The reason why there is some space around flex is because he currently has margin. Remember that the main axis is the axis set in the flex direction, and the cross axis is the other axis. In this case, the cross axis is vertical. When we use justify content, we were setting in the main axis. There's also align items, which defines how the items react to their cross axis. We can use align items flex start, which is the default and which we are using right now to align the cards on top of the row. Let's see what happens if we set align items to flex end. As you can see, the cards were moved to the bottom of the row, and with center, they would obviously be centered in the middle of the row. You can also set just one of the items, using align self, to make it react differently than the other flex items. So far, we have only used flex in a row. Let's switch the flex direction to column and see what happens. It looks like it was in the beginning, but now let's also try the align items, because this time the cross axis is horizontal. As you can see, start will put it on the left, end will put it on the right, and center will put it in the middle. It works just like before, but on a different axis. What happens if the flex items won't fit their flex container? We have flex wrap, which will allow starting a new line when the items won't fit. By default, this is turned off, so your flex items are not allowed to wrap. Let's apply some widths to force some elements to wrap on a new line. And now, let's disable the wrapping again. Now everything is back into one row. Do you remember when we used flex? It is interesting that flex is a shorthand property of three different properties. Flex grow, flex shrink, and flex basis. And when we set flex, we were actually setting all of these in one. Now this might be a little complicated. Flex 1 is actually flex 1, 1, 0, a shorthand in another shorthand. This means 1 flex grow, 1 flex shrink, and 0 for flex basis. Okay, now that we covered that, what exactly are these three properties? The flex basis is the ideal width. It is the width set before distributing the remaining space to the other elements. You can set the flex to stop growing after the flex basis is reached, or to stop it from shrinking if it would be less than the flex basis. Let's see what happens if we set flex to take 5 times as much space as the others. Now let's move on to the next one. Another super powerful feature of flex is ordering the items. you can display the flex items in an order which is not the same as the one in HTML. This can be super beneficial when you are doing responsiveness. Let's set the order value of Amaro to be less than the others, which means that it will become first. And finally, if we set Zane a lesser value than Amara, it will be pushed to first again. Thank you for watching this quick dive into Flexbox. Please like and subscribe if you enjoyed or found this video helpful. Stay learning and keep creating!